Okay, let's get this started. Thank you for coming for the press conference at the FCCJ. My name is Tetsuo Jimbo. I am the co-chair of the committee that's organized the press events here, press events like this. I'm your moderator today. Well, today's guest requires no introduction. Chairman of the Communist Party, Kazuo Shii. And he's been to the club, as far as I remember, this is like third or fourth appearance in the past year. So he's been around a lot. But before we start the press conference, there are two important announcements from the club. Let me just read it. The Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan has invited the leaders of political parties, all political parties that meets the legal conditions of bona fide political party under Japan's public offices election law. While the FCCJ wishes to give all party leaders the opportunity to speak at the club before the upper house election, please understand that there may be cases where some cannot make it because of schedule conflicts or other reasons. And also, please be aware that regardless of whether you are a journalist or not, if you are going to publish a report or a video from today's event and put it up on the internet, including SNS and YouTube, you are likely to be subject to the public office election law if your intended audience is in Japan. 日本語で読みます。外国特派員協会は、公職選挙法上の政党要件を満たすすべての政党の代表に当クラブにおける記者会見の招待状を送付しています。協会としてはすべての政党の代表者の記者会見を開催したいと考えていますが、中にはスケジュールなどの都合で、党の代表に来ていただけない場合もあるかもしれません。なお、この会見をもとに記事や映像リポートを配信される場合、職業がジャーナリストか否かに関わりなく、公職選挙法の対象となりますので、法律の規定にご注意ください。以上です。Okay, so let's start the press conference. Mr. Shii is going to speak up to 15 minutes or so, and then we're going to have a Q&A session after that. So please, Mr. Shii, Shii さん、お願いします。
日本共産党の Shii Kazuoです。今日はご招待いただきましてありがとうございます。
Thank you for the introduction. I am Kazuo Shii, the chairperson of the Japanese Communist Party. I thank you very much for the invitation.
遊説で声が枯れておりまして、お聞き苦しいと思いますが、ご容赦ください。
Well, I have been campaigning these days, and so you can see that I have a coarse throat, and it's difficult for you to hear, but please excuse me.
冒頭私の方から若干の今度の選挙の終盤に臨む基本姿勢をお話しさせていただき、あとはご質問にお答えしたいと思います。
Allow me at the outset to give you some of my comments in regards to our position at this last stage of the election campaign, and then after I would like to take questions.
今度の参議院選挙は文字通り日本の命運がかかった大変重要な歴史的な選挙だと考えております。
Yes, this upper house election, I think that I may well say that Japan's fate is at stake. The destiny of Japan is at stake, and it is a very crucial historic election.
共産党は次の2つの目標にチャレンジし、必ずやり遂げたいと考えております。
The Japanese Communist Party has set out two goals, challenges, and we are aiming to make this happen.
第一は、野党と市民の共闘を必ず成功させることです。
The first objective is to make sure that we are successful in seeing that the opposition camp is successful in winning elections together with the citizens of Japan.
今度の参議院選挙では全国32の1人区のすべてで野党統一候補が実現するという、戦後の日本の政治の歴史でもかつてない画期的な選挙となっております。
Now, in this upper house election, we have fielded 32 opposition unified candidates in the 32 single seat constituency, which is an unprecedented thing, and we think that this is a very innovative thing that has happened.
目下のところ、私たちの 見るところですね。あの共闘のパワーが発揮され、かなりの選挙区で接戦に持ち込んでいると考えております。
Well, we, from our perspective, I think that this campaign coalition is proving to be very powerful, and in a large number of the constituency, we are able to stage a very close race.
あの、我が党としては、この共闘のパワーをですね、まあ、存分に発揮して、32のすべての、選挙区で自民党を打ち負かして、勝利を勝ち取るために、まあ、最後まで力を尽くしたいと決意しております。
And our party, is going to continue to leverage this power of this campaign coalition, so that we can beat the LDP in all these 32 single seat constituencies. We will strive to make this happen until the very last minute.
安倍首相はこの野党共闘の動きに対して、大変な危機感をお持ちのようです。
It seems that Prime Minister Abe has a strong sense of crisis in the face of this opposition's joint campaign.
まあ、彼の言葉からは、まあ、強い恐怖と憎悪が感じられます。
And listening to their words, you can see that they have a strong sense of fear and also hatred.
まあ、様々な攻撃を行っています。
And they are carrying out a number of attacks.
政策が違うものが選挙協力をやることは野望だと彼は言っています。
And what they're saying is that these opposition parties, which have differences in their policies, are working together as merely for the sake of convenience.
しかし野党4党は安保法制の廃止と立憲主義を取り戻すという大義のもとに結束しております。
However, the four opposition parties have this grand objective to, first of all, try to repeal the security legislation that we have in place and restore constitutionalism.
立憲主義を取り戻すというのは、憲法を守る、真っ当な政治を取り戻すということであり、これは、あれこれの政策の違いが仮にあったとしても、それを横に置いてでも、最優先に追求すべき仕事だと考えております。
And we say, when we say restore constitutionalism, this means that we want to defend our constitution and bring about decent politics. Though there might be differences in policies amongst the four opposition parties, we think that we should put aside our differences since this is a top priority issue that we need to pursue together.
あの野党共闘は野望どころか日本に民主政治を取り戻す希望だと私は考えております。
And I believe that the fact that we have this campaign coalition amongst the opposition parties is not for the sake of convenience that we are doing so, but instead this gives hope that we can restore democratic politics.
第二は日本共産党の躍進です。
And the second objective is to have a significant increase in the seats held by the Japanese Communist Party.
私たちは比例代表で850万票以上を獲得し、まあ、9議席の確保を目標としております。
And in our proportional election representation, we plan to secure 8.5 million votes or more, securing 9 seats.
同時に定数2から6の複数定数選挙区での勝利を目標としております。
At the same time, we are aiming to declare victory in the constituency which have multiple seats between 2 to 6 seats.
今の状況ですが、躍進の可能性が生まれていると考えております。
And currently, we believe that there is a possibility that we can achieve such a significant increase.
ただ、比例も選挙区も一票一票争う文字通りの大激戦、大接戦となっております。
However, both in the proportional representation as well as the single and multiple seat constituency, and we are seeing a very close race, and every single vote counts.
躍進の可能性を現実のものにすることができるかどうかは、あと6日間の戦いにかかっております。
and whether or not we can make this possibility of achieving significant increase a reality is left to the 6 days that remain in the campaigning period.
私たちはまあ自力で風を起こして、そして躍進を必ず掴みたいと考えております。
And we say, believe that we can for sure try to create a momentum by our own force and thereby achieve this significant increase.
政策問題について若干述べたいと思います。
Allow me to briefly talk about the policies we have.
さまざまな問題がありますが、2点に絞ってお話しいたします。
Though there are a number of issues, let me focus on two.
一つは、安保法制と憲法改定の問題です。
And one is in regards to the security legislation and the amendment of the Constitution.
私は選挙戦の論戦を通じて、この問題が大争点に浮上してきたと思います。
And through the campaigning, I believe that this issue has become the most contentious issue in the campaign.
もともと安倍首相は、首相在任中に憲法改正を目指すと公言し、この憲法改定に強い執念を燃やしていました。
Now, Prime Minister Abe, since he became Prime Minister, has pledged that he will make sure that this amendment does take place while he is in the position of Prime Minister. And he, ever since, has been insisting on making this happen.
しかし、選挙戦に入りますと、一切憲法を語らなくなりました。
However, once the official campaigning started, he has never made any reference to the Constitution.
憲法各紙でこの選挙をやり過ごそうという姿勢だと思います。
And I believe that he is trying to somehow win this election by hiding this agenda of the Constitution.
しかし、党首討論となりますと、そうはいきません。
However, when it comes to the debate amongst the party leaders, of course he cannot avoid this issue.
安倍さんは問われて、憲法を変えると、しかしどの条文を変えるかは言えないと、このように言いました。
Now, Mr. Abe, when asked whether he will change the Constitution, he has answered yes, but he cannot say which specific clause he is planning to change.
私は安倍さんに、そうはいきませんよと、なぜなら自民党は憲法改正草案を決めている。その中では憲法9条2項を削除し国防軍を保持すると書いてある。もしそうなれば海外での武力の行使が無条件無制限で可能になる。憲法9条に手をつけないと言えますかと尋しました。
Now, I said no way, I cannot accept such an answer. And I stated that the LDP already has a draft constitutional amendment with them where they will delete the second clause of Article 9 and they say that they will maintain a national defense force, meaning that will become possible to unconditionally, without any constraints, to send these forces overseas. So I asked him, can he say clearly that he will not amend whatsoever Article 9.
2つの民法の党首討論で連続的にこの問題を晒してみましたが、安倍さんは手をつけないとは決して言いませんでした。
And I asked the same question in two of the party leaders' debate on commercial television stations, but not once was he able to say that he will not amend Article 9.
まあ彼は手をつけようと思ってますから。
This is because he is planning to amend Article 9.
ですからこうした論戦通じても安倍会見の本丸は憲法9条の改定にあります。これははっきりしました。
So, through these debates, once again, it's become clear that when Abe talks about amending the Constitution, the key here is amending Article 9 of the Constitution.
安倍さんの一貫した野望は、日本をアメリカと肩を並べて海外で戦争ができる国に作り変えることにあります。
Now, Mr. Abe's ambition has constantly been to be equal partners with the United States and to be able to fight wars overseas together with the United States.
彼は安保法制によってその重大な第一歩を踏み出しました。
And with the security legislation, he has made a significant step towards this direction.
それに続いて9条そのものの改定によってこの野望を完成させようとしています。
And by next amending Article 9 of the Constitution, he wants to accomplish this objective.
私は今度の選挙で、安倍自公政権が多数を得たら一挙にこの改憲の具体化が進む危険があると考えております。
And if the LDP Kometo coalition were to win the majority in the upcoming upper house election, I believe that this plan to amend the constitution will quickly become reality. There is such a danger that it will become reality.
日本共産党は憲法9条はあの戦争の大変な犠牲を踏まえて日本国民が手にした世界に誇る宝であると考えておりこれを守り抜くとそしてこれを生かした日本にするということを訴えて戦い抜きたいと思います。
And the Japanese Communist Party would like to say that Article 9 is the result of the many sacrifices that were made by the Japanese people in the past war. And finally, the Japanese people have come to possess this constitution, Pacific Constitution, which we believe is our treasure and something that we can be very proud of in this world. And therefore, we want to continue to defend, uphold this constitution, and create a Japan which can leverage on this constitution. I will continue to appeal this in the campaign to the end.
もう一つはアベノミクスの問題です。
And the other issue is in regards to the Abenomics.
私は3年半の実際を通じてこの失敗をはっきりしたと考えております。
Now, having observed the Abenomics for 3.5 years, I can clearly say that the Abenomics has been a failure.
端的に3つの数字をお話したいと思います。
And I would like to introduce three numbers that prove this.
一つは働く人の実質賃金です。
And one is the real wages of the working people.
5年連続マイナスとなり、5% の目減り、そして1990年度以降、統計が開始されて以降、最低の数字になっています。
Now we have seen that there has been a decline in the real wages for the past 5 years, coming to minus 5%. It is the lowest number since the statistics started to be collected in 1990.
二つ目は、日本経済の6割を占める個人消費です。
And the next is personal consumption, which accounts for 60% of Japan's economy.
これが14年度、15年度と2年連続マイナスです。
And personal consumption for two straight years, FY 2014 and 15, have declined.
2年連続マイナスというのは、戦後初めての異常事態です。
And this is abnormal in the post-war period that we have seen two consecutive years of negative growth.
リーマンショックの際にもマイナスは1年で、次の年にはプラスになりました。今回まさにアベノミクス不況が起こっています。
And even after the Lehman crisis, we did see a negative growth in the year following the Lehman crisis, but then after it turned to a positive. So the fact that we have seen two straight years of negative growth shows that this, we are now experiencing an Abenomics recession.
3つ目はこの間問題になっている問題ことですが、年金の積み立て金の損失の問題です。
And the third issue is in regards to the losses that have been incurred and the pension fund.
アベノミクスはの下で、国民の公的年金を株式に投入し、株を釣り上げるという政策が取られてきました。
Now, under the Abenomics, the policy has been taken so that the asset management of the public pension can be invested more into equity. And by doing so, Abe aimed to increase the share prices.
その結果、2015年度の決算で、5兆円を超える損失が生まれているということが判明しています。
And as a result of such policies, we have clearly seen in the numbers at the close of FY 2015, that the losses have come to 5 trillion yen or more.
最も政府からは公式な発表はされておらず、そのきちんとした発表がされるのは選挙終わっての7月29日ということです。
However, the government has not made any official announcement as of yet, and they are saying that they will make the announcement after the election on July
29. 7月29日というのは私の誕生日ですが、あまり関係ないことですが、いずれにせよですね、選挙の間、正しい通知を知らせないというこの政治性も問題だと思います。
And by the way, July 29th happens to be my birthday, which is irrelevant to this issue. However, the fact that he is unwilling to disclose this number during the election campaign shows in itself that there is a problem with his politics and his attitude towards politics.
私は国民の大事な年金の積立金をですね、リスクの高い株式で運用するというのは邪道だと思っております。
I personally find it unacceptable the fact that he would opt to enable the pension funds, which is the precious premiums collected contributions collected by the people for after retirement, to enable this money to be invested in more risky equities.
アメリカでは公的年金の株式運用は禁止されておりますが、これが当たり前の姿だと考えます。
In the United States, asset management of the public pension cannot invest in stocks. I think that it is only natural that such a policy be taken.
3つの数字を挙げましたが、いろんな角度から見てアベノミクスが失敗したことは明らかです。
I gave three numbers here, but looking at this from different perspectives, it is clear that Abenomics has failed.
私たち日本共産党はこのアベノミクスのに対する抜本的な対案として、格差を正し、経済に民主主義を、経済にデモクラシーをという提唱をしております。
Now, we, as a counter, excuse me, counter proposal to the Abenomics, have come up with the following policy. The Japanese Communist Party is saying that we want to correct the disparity in society and bring about democracy to economics.
3つのチェンジということを訴えています。
And we are appealing for three changes.
1つは税金の集め方のチェンジです。
And one is the way we change taxes.
消費税頼みの道をやめて、富裕層と大企業に応分の負担を求める税制改革を行います。
And we will do away with the dependence on consumption tax revenue and instead try to get the rich and the large companies to pay the taxes which they are capable of paying.
2つ目は税金の使い方のチェンジです。
And the second is the change in how to use the tax revenue.
税金は社会保障と若者と子育てに優先して使うべきだということで、それぞれについて具体的な政策を提唱しております。
And we believe that we should prioritize using the tax revenue on social security, youth and child rearing. And we have specific policies to make this happen.
3つ目は働き方のチェンジです。
And the third is to change the way people work.
ブラック企業をなくし、長時間労働を規制し、過労死をなくしていきます。
And that is to say, to do away with the companies which are called the black companies on the blacklist, and also to limit the long working hours, and also to rid of karoshi, which is death due to excessive work.
最悪の数字になっている非正規社員から正社員への流れを作る、雇用のルールを強化します。
And also we will strengthen the labor rules so that we can try to make the irregular workers, which are the highest number currently, into regular workers.
まあ、最低賃金を今すぐどこでも時給1000円、そして中小企業への支援をやりながら1500円に引き上げる、こういうことも提案しております。
And as for the minimum wages, we are proposing that no matter where the person works, the hourly wages should be at least 1,000 yen per hour. And by supporting the SMEs, small and medium enterprises, to make the minimum wage 1,500 yen per hour.
全体として財界応援から暮らし応援に経済政策の舵を切り替えようというのが共産党の提唱です。
And therefore, overall, our Japanese Communist Party's policy is to make a change in the economic policy, switching from the financial community-based approach, focused approach, to focus on the livelihood of the Japanese people.
その他の問題では PPP、原発、沖縄の米軍基地の問題、こうした問題も重視し、安倍政権による強権的な政治を許さず、その転換を求めていくこともそれぞれ重視して戦っております。
And we also looking into other issues such as TPP and nuclear energy and the U.S. military bases in Okinawa, amongst others. We are focusing on these issues and trying to put a stop to Abe's high-handed political policies and bring about a change. And these are the focus points of our campaigning.
全体のアウトラインはこんなところです。あとはご質問にお答えしたいと思います。ありがとうございました。
And that concludes my outline explanation. And from here and after, I would like to take questions. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Shii. So we're going to go to the Q&A. Please once again check your cell phone. The cell phone tends to start ringing toward the second half of the press conference. But put that in the manner mode. And also, I forgot to introduce our interpreter today. Our interpreter today is Yoriko Konuma. Okay, so we're going to go to the Q&A, and I'd like to try to get as many questions as possible. So please, let's not make any speeches, the questions only. And let's say one question per person, and then if we have time, we're going to go to the second round. Okay, so and we're going to start with the working press table. So anyone from the working press first? Yeah, please raise hands. Anthony's hands was first. Anthony, go ahead.
Anthony Rowley, Singapore Business Times. Given the question marks over the success of Abenomics, and also given the question of the constitutional revision, these are two very controversial subjects. One might assume the opposition is going to do very well in the election. Do you share that confidence, or what do you think could work against you actually being able to capitalize on these issues? Mm-hmm.
ビジネスタイムズのアンサニーと申しますけれども、今現在アベノミクスの成功に関する疑問を呈していらっしゃいましたし、そしてもう一つ会見の問題についても触れられました。いずれも今大変物議を醸している問題だと思いますし、野党としてはこういったところをつくことによって躍進できるとの自信を持っていらっしゃるようでありますけれども、逆に何か野党にとって不利に働くようなそういった可能性のある問題というのはないのでしょうか。
難しい質問ですね。
A difficult question.
私は今の、全体の日本の政治の中で野党が、政権与党との関係でこの問題は、不利だという問題は存在してないと思っております。どの分野の問題でも私たちは自信を持っております。
Well, as a matter of fact, looking at the Japanese politics today and looking at the opposition's policies versus the ruling coalition's policies, I don't think that there is any single issue in which we believe that the oppositions are at a disadvantage against the LDP or the Komeito. So that is my position.
Okay, next question. Anyone from the working table, working press table? You have no question. Okay, so while you guys think about the next question, I'm gonna just take a liberty of asking a question then. I have a question about the so-called communist allergy. Okay, there's a lot of talk about Kyosanto allergy, the communist allergy, and whether it's true or not. Why do you think such a notion still exists as far as you are concerned, Mr. Shii? And if there is actually a reason for that, what is the Communist Party doing in order to basically lower this allergy?
はい、では私の方からワーキングプレスが質問を考えている間に質問させていただきたいと思います。まあ、世に言う共産党アレルギー、という言葉があります。でこれが、まあ、真実であるか否かとは関係なく、やはり、こういった概念が依然として存在をしているということ、これはなぜでしょうか。新委員長からご覧になって、理由がどこにあるというふうに考えられているでしょうか。そしてその理由が分かっていらっしゃるならば、それに対してどのようにしてこのアレルギーを少しでも解消しようとしていらっしゃるのか教えてください。
これはいろんな原因が考えられます。
Well, I think that there are various reasons that you could think of.
一つは歴史的に共産主義といいますと崩壊した、まあ、旧ソ連を連想する方も多いかと思います。
Now, first, historically speaking, I think that there are many people, when they hear of communism, would opt to be reminded of the former Soviet Union, which collapsed.
私たちはソ連共産党と激しい論争を行ってきました。
However, we have been having fierce debates with the Soviet Communist Party.
ソ連型の社会は外交でも内政でも社会主義とは無縁の社会だということを私たちはその論争の結果としてそういう認識を得ております。
And we believe, as a result of the various debates that we have had, and concluded that the former Soviet Union, be it in the field of diplomacy or internal policies, politics, it has nothing whatsoever to do with socialism.
ソ連が行ったような対外的な覇権主義、国内的な専制主義、こうしたものは一切退けると。で自由と民主主義を将来にわたって擁護し発展させるとこういう確固たる立場を私持っております。
And therefore, we will never try to accept any of the hegemony that the Soviet Union has tried to stage overseas, as well as autocracy. And therefore, instead, what we are trying to expand and uphold is freedom and democracy into the future.
しかしこうした私たちの、姿をですねまだ国民の皆さんに伝えきっていないところでいろいろな誤解もあればいわゆるアレルギーというものも存在すると思います。
However, because we have not been able to fully communicate this, our position to the Japanese public, yes, it is true that there are misconceptions and so-called allergy.
これは私たちの努力でなくしていく努力をしたいと思います。
And we would like to make every effort so that we can eliminate such misconceptions and allergy.
またこういうことはあるかもしれません。
And another reason might be the following.
共産党は独善的だと、独り善がりだと、こういう批判も あるかもわかりません。
And it might be that some criticize the Communist Party by saying that it's dogmatic, self-centered.
私たちは国政選挙では必ず独自の候補を擁立するという方針を一貫して選挙を取ってきました。
And in the post-war period, we have in all direct elections fielded independent candidates.
それはそれで私は原則に立った対応だったと思っております。
And I believe that this was a response based on our principle that we fielded our independent candidates in all constituencies.
しかしそうした共産党の姿を見て、共産党は独善的ではないかという評価を。
But it might be looking at this fact that some people thought that the Japanese Communist Party was self-centered.
これまではそうした国政選挙での協力の条件というのは実はありませんでした。
But in the past, in the general elections, national elections, there were no conditions in place for us to cooperate with other parties.
しかし、今回はまさに協力すべき時だし、そのことは協力することは私たちの責任だと考えて方針を転換いたしました。
However, this time we thought this is the time for us to cooperate, and there was a need for us to cooperate. And therefore, we took this responsible decision so as to change our policy.
今32の一人区のすべてで、共産党が民進党の皆さん、あるいは社民党や生活党の皆さん、市民の皆さんと肩を並べて、
And therefore, in all the 32 single-seat constituencies, together with the Democratic Party, as well as the People's Lives Party, and also the Social Democratic Party, plus the citizens, we are staging this campaign.
そういう姿を見て、共産党に対する見方を肯定的な方向に。 変えた方も少なくないのではないかと私は考えております。
And I believe that there are quite a few people looking at the Japanese Communist Party's position like this have taken a different view, a more positive view towards our party.
Okay. そのところです。
Okay. That's all.
Thank you. Okay, so your hands up first, then after you. Go ahead.
Hi, my name is Walter. I'm from the Straits Times in Singapore. My question has to do with security threats in the region, be it East China Sea as well as terrorism. What does the JCP think of the government's response to security threats thus far, and in what areas do you think it can be better? Thank you.
はい、私、ウォルターと申します。シンガポールのストレートタイムズ氏から参りました。今、現在、周囲にある様々な脅威について、お聞きしたいんですけれども、東シナ海であれ、また、テロの脅威であれ、日本共産党として今の政権の、これらの安全保障上の脅威に対する対応、どのように見ていらっしゃるのか、そして日本共産党としては、こういった対応の仕方の方がより良いと、考えていらっしゃる改善点
があればおっしゃっていただきたいと思います。様々な脅威に対する対応についてのご質問ですが、まず国際テロの問題について若干話したいと思います。
Well, you've asked about different types of threats, but let me try to respond to you by first talking about international terrorism.
私たちは元よりどんな理由であれ卑劣なテロを断固として
And first of all, I must make clear that no matter what the reason may be, we cannot accept such atrocities such as terrorism.
ただ、これをなくす方法は私は国際社会の一致協力して警察と司法の力、また政治的外交的な協力によって根絶していくと。 これが基本だと考えております。
Now, as to the method of how to eliminate such international terrorism, I believe that the international community needs to be united and cooperate. Also, the police and judiciary have to cooperate. And also, I believe that there is need for political diplomatic cooperation in order to eradicate terrorism.
例えば IS という組織がどうして生まれたのか。
For example, why did IS, Islamic State, emerge?
それは、アフガニスタン戦争、イラク戦争が生み出したモンスターであるということは、当事者のブレアさん、あるいは、オバマ氏も事実を認めています。
Now, this is a monster which was born as a result of the Afghanistan war and also the Iraqi war. And both Mr. Blair and even Mr. Obama have admitted this fact.
戦争でテロリズムをなくすことはできません。
And therefore, we cannot eradicate terrorism through wars.
テロと戦争の悪循環を作るだけだというのが歴史の教訓ではないでしょうか。
And I think history tells us that terrorism and war, we will only create such a vicious cycle by continuing to take this path.
テロ根絶のためには冒頭言ったように、警察と司法の力、政治的外交的な努力、テロの温床になっている貧困の解決、あるいは宗派間のさまざまな対立を解消するための努力、こういう総合的な努力が必要だと思います。
And therefore, in order to eradicate terrorism, as I said at the outset, we need to rely on police forces, also the judiciary branch, as well as political diplomacy. And also, there is need to try to eliminate poverty, which is the root of terrorism. Also, there is need to make effort to try to do away with the religious factions, conflicts. And so, there needs to be a comprehensive approach taken.To eradicate terrorism.
もう一つ、この北東アジアの平和と安定をどう築くかという問題のご質問についてであります。
And next, the second part of your question was in regards to how to restore realized peace in Northeast Asia.
この地域にさまざまな紛争と緊張の火種が存在することは事実です。
And yes, it is true that there are hotspots which could lead to conflicts or wars.
ただ私たちは軍事の挑発に対して日本が軍事で構えるということになれば、軍事対軍事のいわば悪循環が生まれてきます。
However, if Japan were in the face of military threat, try to carry out a military response, then it would evolve into a military versus military vicious cycle.
どんな問題も対話による解決、外交的解決に徹する、そういう平和のルールをこの地域に作る必要があります。
And therefore, there is need to establish a rule in this region so that no matter what the problem will be, the problems should be resolved through diplomatic solutions.
この点で私たちが注目しているのは、ASEAN の国々の努力です。
And here we are focusing on the efforts being made by the ASEAN nations.
ASEAN では東南アジア友好協力条約 TACのを中心としてあらゆる紛争問題を平和的な話し合いで解決する、平和の枠組みがしっかり形作られています。
And by that we mean that in Southeast Asia there is the Treaty of Amity and Cooperation which is the peace framework to try to resolve all disputes through peaceful negotiations.
例えば南シナ海のをめぐる紛争があります。
For example, there are the disputes in the South China Sea.
私たちは今の南シナ海での中国の乱暴な振る舞いに対しては、厳しい批判の立場を表明しています。
And when it comes to China's assertiveness in the South China Sea, we have made publicly clear that our position is that we strongly condemn such action.
しかし、この問題の解決の方法は対話しかありません。
However, in order to resolve this issue, we can only rely on dialogue.
南シナ海と中国は南シナ海行動宣言DOCを結んでいます。
And because in the South China Sea, ASEAN and China have entered into a DOC for the South China Sea.
COC, Code of Conduct, に発展させる努力を今しています。
And they're making effort to try to develop this into COC, Code of Conduct.
紛争が起こっても、それを戦争にしない、それをエスカレートさせない。 そのためのそういう枠組みを努力して作っています。
In other words, they're making effort to set the framework so that these disputes do not evolve into war and escalate.
日本共産党の提案は、この ASEAN が実践しているような紛争を話し合いで解決する平和の地域共同の枠組みをですね、北東アジアにも作るべきだと。
And the Japanese Communist Party is thinking of emulating what ASEAN is doing in order to try to resolve disputes through dialogue. We believe that such a framework can also be established in Northeast Asia, and we are calling for a Northeast Asia Peace Cooperation Initiative.
TAC と同じような 友好協力条約をですね、北東アジア規模で締結する、あるいは領土に関する紛争問題をエスカレートさせない行動規範を作る等々の具体的な柱からなる、この地域のですね、ASEAN方式の地域の平和協力の機構、平和協力の枠組みをですね、作りたいというのが私たちの提案です。
And therefore, our party's proposal is to try to establish a TAC, Treaty of Amity and Cooperation-like structure in Northeast Asia. And when it comes to, for example, the territorial disputes, again, we will try to prevent this from escalating by establishing a code of conduct. So we do have specific pillars, policies in place so that we are going to try to establish such a peace cooperation initiative like the ASEAN in this region.
私自身この提案を持ってですね、日本の周辺の諸国にも対話を重ねてきました。日本政府にもこの提案をしております。日本政府にも。
And so I have taken this proposal to our neighboring countries, and I'm calling on dialogue. And I've also made this proposal to the Japanese government.
今日本に求められているのは軍事的対応の強化ではなくて、救助の精神に立ったそういう平和の外交戦略が必要だというのが私たちの考えです。
And therefore, our position is that in order to respond to such threats, Japan should not be trying to enhance, strengthen its military strength, but instead, it should focus on such peaceful diplomatic measures.
Okay, more questions? Okay, どうぞ、 石田さん、 どうぞ。
ありがとうございました。インターネット、ニュースサイト、バズフィードジャパンというところで記者をしている石戸と申します。アベノミクスの政策についてちょっとお伺いしたいことがあります。アベノミクスというのは、基本的には1本目は金融、2本目は財政、3本目は規制緩和というのに成り立っています。で、 1本目の特にその1本目の金融政策についてお伺いたいと思います。で、1本目の金融政策については、リベラル系の、リベラル、あるいは左派系の経済学者からもですね、健全な経済成長のためには必要であるというような一定の評価を与える声があります。この点について、新委員長の見解をお聞かせください。で、合わせて、共産党は経済成長というものに関してどのような考え方を持っているか、必要かどうかという点と、あるいは必要だとするとどのような成長が望ましいと考えているかという点を お聞かせください。すいません。あと5分さい。これは、さらに3点目でちょっと、経済政策とはちょっと関係ないんですけども、透明について伺いたいと思います。昔から、共産党は透明を変更したらいいんじゃないかというような声は 共産党アレルギーの関連ですね、よく聞かれたと思います。まあ、野党共闘などを経て、新委員長、その辺のお考えが、変わったかどうかという点をお聞かせいただければ幸いでございます。
Yes, thank you very much. My name is Ushido from this internet media. But yes, first I'd like to ask about the Abenomics. And there are three arrows involved here. The first being the financial policy, second fiscal, and third is deregulation. I'm going to ask you about the first arrow in regards to the financial policies. Liberal and the left-wing economists are saying that this type of economic or growth is healthy and necessary, and they are supporting the Abenomics to a certain extent. But what is your take on this? Plus, I'd like to ask what the Japanese Communist Party's position is on economic growth. Do you think it's necessary? And if so, what kind of growth is necessary? Thirdly, and this is a different topic, about the name of your party, the Japanese Communist Party. Due to the allergy that was described, some people have been calling for a change in your party's name. Now that you are collaborating with the other opposition parties, have you changed your mind? Do you have any ideas to change the name of your political party?
まず安倍政権の金融政策の問題ですが、まあ要は異次元の金融緩和ということで、人為的に円安を作り出し、海外から投機バネを呼び込んで、株高を作ると、で株を釣り上げるというやり方で経済を回していくというやり方だったと思います。
Well, in regards to your question about the Abenomics and the monetary policy, yes, he has at an abnormal, unprecedented level carried out monetary easing to the extent where he has artificially tried to weaken the yen, invite overseas speculative investors, create money as a result of such speculative investment, and thereby increase the stock prices. And this is what he has tried to do.
いや一口で言いますと、投機マネー頼みの円安株高政策をずっとやってきたということだと思います。
In other words, put it another way, he has been constantly carrying out this speculative money dependent depreciation of the yen and share price increase.
こういうやり方というのは、私は日本経済を大変脆いものにしてしまっていると思います。
And I believe that such an approach is making the Japanese economy fragile.
例えば、EU からのイギリスの離脱によるショックというのは世界中を襲いましたが、日本では特にその為替や株への影響は大きなものになりました。
And for example, the issue of Brexit. This came as a shock to the global economy, but in particular in Japan, I think Japan was very hard hit, both in the foreign exchange as well as the stock market.
投機マネー頼み、金融頼みで、この、まあ、張り子の虎のように膨らました経済。しかし、実体経済は冷え込む一方ですから、大変経済の実質は脆いものにしてしまいました。
Because he has been through speculative investments and such monetary policies and been trying to balloon the economy, whereas the real economy was declining, and as a result, he has made the real economy very fragile.
私はそうした投機マネー頼み、金融頼みの経済からですね、内需主導の経済に転換する必要がある。内需の中でもその中心は家計ですから。家計を応援する、個人消費を応援する、そして健全な成長をしていくような経済への転換が必要だと考えております。
And therefore, I think that up until now, we have been seeing this speculative investment, monetary dependent economy, whereas our thinking is to change this to a domestic demand-led economy. When we say a domestic internal demand, this is the households which are going to be the main players. So we have to support the households and personal consumption. And by increasing personal consumption, we will be able to realize a healthy economic growth. And this is the change that is required.
それから成長についてのご質問ですが、私たちはそうした内需主導、そして家計が活発になって、そして GDP が全体として健全な成長の軌道に乗る、そうした健全な成長は必要だと考えております。
Yes, and about the growth, the type of growth that you asked, yes, our thinking is that it should be domestic demand led, the households should be spending, and as a result, the GDP on the whole should be increased. So we think that that is the healthy growth path that Japan should be taking.
この点で、安倍政権の成長論というのは、簡単に言えば大企業を応援し、大企業が儲ければいずれは家計に回り、そして成長するという考えだったんですが、このトリクルダウン式の成長論は失敗したと思います。
Now, whereas the Abe administration's policy was to first support the big companies, and once the big companies were to be successful and profitable, and this will benefit the households of the workers who are working there and bring about growth. This trickle-down type of growth has not worked.
トリクルダウンではなくて、庶民の家計を応援する。そして、働く人の賃金を増やし、所得を増やす、そこから経済を立て直して好循環を作っていく、これが本当の意味での成長をに日本経済を乗せていく唯一の道だと考えております。
And therefore, instead of this trickle-down approach, we think that it is better to support the people and the households to give them wages, enough wages to the working population so as to rebuild our economy. We believe that making such a virtuous cycle will, in the true sense of the word, bring about growth. And I think that this is the only way that the Japanese economy can truly recover.
最後に透明の問題ですが、私たちはこれは大事に使っていきたいと思っております。
And your last question about the name of our party, we want to treasure our name.
一言で言いまして、私たちは人類の社会は資本主義で終わりだと考えておりません。
Now, simply put, we don't think that when it comes to the history of mankind, capitalism is not the end.
人類はこの矛盾に満ちた社会を乗り越えて、次の社会、未来社会に進む力を持っているというのが私たちの確信です。
And we are confident that mankind can overcome this society full of contradiction and open the way to a new future society.
政党はその透明に自らの理想を刻むのが最も誠実な態度だと考えており、私たちの透明はこのまま未来にわたって大事に使っていきたいというのは私の考えです。
And therefore, I believe that it is only sincere and truthful that we try to reflect our ideal in our name, and therefore we will retain this party name into the future and cherish this name.
Okay, I'm going to have just one more question. Yeah, go ahead.
Siegfried Knittel writing for the Austrian newspaper, The Standard. Japanese people don't believe in Mr. Abe's policy. They're against the nuclear policy. They're against, they don't believe in Abenomics. They don't believe in his security laws last year. But in the polls, still Mr. Abe is popular.Still has a popularity rate of 50%. People see Mr. Abe, even if they don't agree with his policy, they see him as only leader, possible leader. Well, how to deal with this?
はい、オーストリアの新聞媒体からもありましたけれども、日本人の方々は決してアベノミクス、安倍総理の政策を信じておりません。例えば原発には反対してますし、そしてアベノミクスも信じておりませんし、まあ、昨年、この可決されました安保法制に関しても決していいとは思っておりません。にもかかわらず世論調査の結果を見ますと、なぜか支持率が高い、50% を上回るような支持率になっております。つまり国民は、政策そのものに対しては賛成をしていない、にもかかわらず安倍が唯一のリーダーであるというふうに考えているようでありますが、市委員長はそれに対してどのように対抗されますでしょうか。
おっしゃるように、安倍政権の進めている個々の政策に国民の強い批判が寄せられています。
Well, as you rightly mentioned, yes, the people are strongly critical about the various policies of the Abe administration.
にもかかわらず一定の内閣支持率が高いのはなぜかというご質問ですが、これは野党の側がどれだけ対案を示していけるか、オルタナティブを示せるか、これに勝っていると思っております。
Well, and yet you say that the approval rating is very high, and you question this. But I think that whether or not this can change is left to the opposition camp as to how much of alternatives we can present to the people.
で、今日発表された世論調査では、今度の選挙で与党が安定多数を取ってほしいか、野党が伸びてほしいかという質問に対して、野党が伸びてほしいという答えのが多いんですね。これまた事実なんです。
And yes, looking at the results of the poll survey that was announced today, it seems that compared to those who answered that they would like to see that the ruling coalition acquire a stable majority, more responded that they would like to see the opposition camp increase their seats.
ですからおっしゃるように、安倍政権の個々の政策に反対している。また一強支配と言われるいわゆる今の状況は何とかしてほしい、ここまでは国民の皆さんの気持ちははっきりしていると思います。
And therefore I think that at least when it comes to the respective policies of the Abe administration and also the fact that this is this single party rule in Japan, up to that point it is clear that the Japanese people are not thinking of this as a desirable situation.
で問題は野党が安倍政権に代わる外交経済の面での別の選択肢をきちんと提示できるか、ここにかかっていると思います。
So the question is whether or not the opposition can present alternatives, alternative choices, to the Abe administration's diplomatic economic policies.
私たちはこの間の野党共闘の取り組みの中で野党の共通政策を作る努力をしてきました。
And through our coalition, the opposition's campaign coalition, we have been trying to put together those policies which we have in common.
安保制の問題、憲法の問題、アベノミクスの問題、TPP、沖縄、そういう一連の国政の基本問題で、基本的なスタンスは共通のものを確認しています。
And we were able to confirm where it came to the basic positions regarding the security legislation, the constitution, Abenomics, TPP, and Okinawa. We think that we have common ground.
さらに野党4党として15本の議員立法を共同で提出しております。それから19項目の政策協定を市民連合の皆さんとの間に結んでいます。合わせて、34項目のさまざまな細目にわたる政策的な合意があります。
And talking about the four opposition parties in the coalition, there are 15 legislations proposed by the legislators. Also, there are 19 items, policy items, that have been agreed amongst the parties. And therefore, in total, there are 34 items, various specific items, on which the four opposition parties have reached an agreement.
もちろん政策の違いもあります。
Of course, naturally, there are differences in our policies as well.
しかし今の野党連合として 最大限の政策というのは一致点を国民の皆さんにお示しして今選挙を戦っています。
However, we as a campaign coalition are presenting to the public these policies where we are united and trying to show it to the maximum.
一回野党に任せてみようというふうに国民の皆さんに評価していただけるように残る6日間頑張ってですね、野党の勝利のために力を尽くしたいと考えています。
And therefore, we would like to spend the remaining 6 days of the campaign and putting everything into it so that the Japanese people will feel confident that they can leave it to the opposition to run the government.
Okay, I think we are running out of time. Thank you very much. As a sign of appreciation, I would like to present Mr. Shii a 1 year honorary membership. He already has maybe two or three of those, but your honorary membership is just extended for by 1 year. So thank you very much, and come back again. Thank you. And thank you. Thank you for coming to the press conference at FCCJ.